Hi, I'd like to change my power outlet right there. Why? Because this is where I sit at our dining table to work and edit my videos and stuff, and I have to plug into that crappy power outlet.
Even the seats are falling apart under my weight. I guess I have to reupholster these myself? You know what? I'll make a video about it and post it on my new channel, Meditation.
Subscribe to my new channel.
But that's not the point. These stupid sockets. In fact, all our sockets in our home have lost their grip on the plugs. Anything I plug in them just slips out. I don't know what the previous tenant has shoved in them. See, it's like a limp. I guess it's not the male side's problem. It's the female side lost its springiness and doesn't grab the prongs well. Sometimes I bend the prongs like this so that it can hold on a bit better. But let's just change this one. First, you remove the cover. Then we unscrew the outlet and pull it out. Ow!
See, the North American outlets look like this, and these side screws are connected to live and neutral wire. So if you grab them like this, it will shock the shit out of you. So it's safest before starting to work on these to open the breaker. Also, the isolating gloves help too.
Now, a bunch of you might say that the UK plugs are the safest in universe, or the European or Australian outlets are the best or whatever. And you're probably right, but in our continent, we are stuck with this junk.
Why do you think we use 120 volt AC instead of 220 or 240? Somebody knew that using these, we would better keep our voltage down or everyone would die. Anyway, you can either tighten these screws to hold the wires or just plug them into these holes to keep them tight. Same power lines in both sockets are shorted together using these tiny bridges. In fact, let me show you something.
In some of the outlets, especially in the kitchen, they bring two phases to the outlet. And to do so, if you look here carefully, they have to cut that tiny bridge.
Damn it. I have to learn to open the breaker.
The bridge is totally annihilated now. Anyway, I showed you in my previous video that these two phases are 120 degrees out of phase to create around 208 volt AC. It might be a high-rise thing. I've heard that in houses they have a center tap transformer to make 220 volts 180 degrees out of phase to create a 240 volt AC. Yeah.
Okay, now that we have the breaker open, we just snip the live and neutral wires and unscrew the ground wire.
Then we, what was it called, nudify around a centimeter length of the wire. I don't know if I get demonetized if I show naked wires. Then we just push these wires into the holes nice and tight. And also connect the ground. Also tighten these screws all the way down so they're not hanging out for no reason, shocking people. Like Trump on Twitter. Now before I put it all the way together, let's double check to see if it works. I powered the outlet and connected the scope and there you go. It's probably fine, but let's just probe the signal to be sure. And remember that the white wire is neutral and that's where you would be connecting your probe ground. The f***ing white wire was neutral. I connected it backwards. Remember to read where to plug the black and white wires from the back of this outlet. It's written right there. White wire is neutral connected to these wider slots and black is live connected to these smaller ones and earth ground is connected to these semicircle holes. And we are done. Just screw the outlet back onto the wall nice and straight. Now where did I put the faceplate? Son of a... buy a new one and put the cover plate on nice and straight and now just check it with a regular light bulb and there, done. It's a very easy task to do. Just remember, if you do this and you make a mistake and the house burns down and insurance figures out that you did it and you are not certified, you'll probably go homeless. So the question is, are you gonna let the fear of insurance control your life? A real man never worries about mistakes until it's too late. Oh, by the way, I'm doing a presentation in Bay Area Maker Faire. I could use some test subjects. If you're around, I would be happy to meet you.